In this episode, we talk about why you should study with a team and hack your way through engineering with group success. What's up, everyone? This is Jake Voorhees, and you are watching episode 21 of the 1% Engineer Show. For this show, we're touching on principle 3 of Dale Carnegie's How to Win Friends and Influence People, how to nudge people into helping you just by framing conversation in their perspective. Not yours. No one cares. The core of this principle is you should arouse in the other person an eager want. To get what you may want from that person, you have to stop thinking in terms of what you need, what you want, and think about it from their shoes. What can you do for them? How can you help them? What is it that they actually want? And how can you become mutually beneficial as you talk about things from their perspective, and in turn, you're achieving your goals as well? We've talked about this before, and this is a core foundational principle in Dale Carnegie's book that will help you win friends and influence people. Okay, what does all this mean? How can this apply to you? Let me give you an example of my time in engineering and how you can probably cross-apply this to your world for success. Again, I always encourage the 1% engineers to work in teams, to study for exams as a group, to do homework as a group. It helps out a lot. It makes things faster, easier. If you're stuck, maybe someone else will get the problem. You help each other learn. And just like Aristotle said, 1 + 1 sometimes equals 3. And you guys are actually smarter as a group, smarter as a team, and it just makes it better. But the problem lots of students have is they're afraid to approach other students in their class, to ask them to do homework together, to ask them to study for an exam together. They don't know what to say. They don't know what to do. They're too shy. They're quiet. Things like this. But this is one thing you can do. What used to work for me is I would study with kids who were smarter than me. You have to think about what you can add to them. How can you help them? A lot of these super smart A++++ students, they don't want to present. They may not be the most organized. They may not want to write the project reports. They may not want to write up the homework lab for whatever class you're taking. So think about what you can do to make their homework situation easier, to make that project better for them, to make studying for this exam better for them. Maybe you can organize all the exam questions and create a study guide or something, but you have to think about what you can help them with. You have to think about what they may not want to do themselves. My highlight example for myself was projects. I would present, I would have the relationship with the professor because these other students who were 4.0 people, they didn't always want to go to the professor and ask them questions and take lead on the project. Even though they may have been the brains behind the operation, they didn't necessarily want to be the person with the mic or the person who would kick off the presentation. And this is what I could add to them. So you have to think about what you can do for these other students who are getting great grades, who are sitting in the front, who you know are superstars, who are probably gonna have more opportunities just because they're outperforming other students. And you wanna work with them because these are the A-listers. You wanna be doing homework with them, group stuff with them, projects with them. So what can you do for them? Frame the approach in terms of how it benefits them. You have to instill that eager want in them. Consider the situation from their shoes. How can you help them? And you will win. They will want to work with you. And you guys can all help each other on your road to completion of this course. And then you will probably work together in other courses and things like this. You'll just be more successful together. So in summary today, guys, you have to put situations in terms of the interests of the other person. And now they really want to listen to you. They want to work with you. They eagerly want to be a part of whatever you're proposing, so it becomes a win-win situation and you guys can study together, work together, do exam things together, be a team, and probably have a relationship that locks in forever, and you guys will end up referring each other for jobs in your careers and keep in touch and have a super awesome professional relationship forever because you guys helped each other. And it all starts with you framing things regarding their interests, how you can help them. Always think about the value that you can add to this person and why they want to listen to you and be a part of that situation. So talk in terms of what they want, and you will find if you lead with their interests, a win-win scenario will happen. And you will prevail in the end. So that's how you can apply principle 3 of how to win friends and influence people. Hit the subscribe button, guys, so you don't miss out on future episodes. Thanks for watching the 1% Engineer Show, guys, and stay hungry on your quest to become a 1% engineer. Cheers.